Yo, what is up, YouTube? Hope you guys are doing well. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Brema, and in today's episode, we'll be going through a bit of a documentation of where our brand is at currently and the progression that we're having within the brand. So this week is actually really chaotic, so we're really capturing the true essence of what our day-to-day and what that looks like. So we have a lot of like new development with the brand, really a lot of improvement with the product that we'll showcase throughout this episode. We're filming a documentary with the film crew from Russia. Really excited about this project because they put a lot of energy into this documentary, and we'll be doing interviews and then also like the B-rolls for it as well. And again, we also did a big purchase for the company, and then we're also preparing for our Milwaukee pop-up, which is happening July 1st to the 16th in Milwaukee. And then alongside doing a flea market before we leave LA, so the Black Flea Market, which is a really cool part of the community to be involved in and just being part of like the LA culture. So I really hope you guys enjoy this episode. It's a lot that's happening, but it's also like really true, genuine moments and feelings of this past week.
Can you explain what this is?
So we just got back all of our product from the finishing house, meaning we got all the t-shirts, hoodies, sweatpants, and shorts relabeled, re-tagged, and ready for retail. This stuff will be transported back to Milwaukee for our pop-up shop.
All of it?
All of it, yes. It's over 1,000 units. So.
How many boxes?
38 boxes.
Jeez.
Yeah, so let me just bring this back downstairs.
So it's all tagged and ready?
Yes, sir.
Hell yeah, bro.
Let's go. Crazy.
As you guys could see, this is such a huge jump for the brand for us. Like, this is a nice progression, getting all our products tagged and everything like that. It just ups our quality a little bit. It's something that we've been looking forward to as a brand. And I think just to look back, it's a form of like graduation. So really, really excited for this moment. I'm also currently doing an interview for the documentary project that we're working on. So. This is a practice run, just running through everything. So the film crew that we're shooting with, I initially came across George, who's been really instrumental to making this project come to life through Instagram. I really liked his work initially when I landed on his page. I think through just like browsing other cinematographers and whatnot through Instagram, messaged him right away. Was like, oh, we'd love to do something together. But at the time, I think he was living in New York. But then when they moved out to LA, I told him that we were also moving to LA. So we ended up just linking up. They came to the office, did a tour. got a firsthand story of the brand, and they were really like interested in the whole story, and they really wanted to capture and make a documentary piece out of it, and really excited to be doing this project with them. So the importance of this documentary is to be able to share our story through a different lens. So the film crew is from Russia, and it's really cool to be able to share our story with them. They have a whole new perspective on what our brand is, and they're taking that story and dissecting it and forming a visual piece from it, which I'm really excited for. So far, they've put so much energy into it. And I'm excited to share this piece with you guys to see where our story is told by a different group.
Maybe you can move the chair somehow, like, more comfortable. Because I think before,
Could you just give me a spiel about like what's going on with the whole documentary you guys are doing?
Oh.
Something short, you know.
Wow,
that's too
difficult
in-depth.
To be in front of the camera. We're making a documentary about the philosophy of the brand. We want to create something meaningful, as well. I think it's aligned a lot with the brand philosophy. And we are collaborating with each other on the project, I think the same way as you guys do with your brand. And I feel the most alive when I'm doing something like that, and I'm super happy, and thank you for...
Sweet. Yeah, what's your role in the whole thing?
Oh, that's difficult. actually, that's a great question.
Yeah.
We're all just doing things that we like, and I interviewed Drema, and I like to overthink everything in life, and I'm really happy that now I can find, I found an outlet for that quality in myself.
That's awesome. Sweet. So you're directing this whole thing, right?
Co-directing,
kind of.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Man. Sweet.
Yeah, a lot. Like from almost like a producer role too, because you're coming up with the questions. And
being creative producer.
Yeah.
Sweet. Cool. Thank you. I appreciate it. It is Friday. Yeah. We've been shooting this documentary the past day or. Kind of 2 days, right?
Yeah, 2 days. 2 days shooting.
This is the kind of the third day, anyway.
The first day was the rehearsal, so just doing interview questions and rehearsing.
Yeah, and then what else is going on too? We just got a bunch of items with tags. I kind of documented that too. We got the tags back, right?
Yeah.
Let's talk about that, quick.
I think. Right now, we're as a brand, we're progressing a lot with our product and also just storytelling and building community. So moved out here initially to LA to pursue the brand and like grow it. It's a lot of like product development. So getting tagged product was a step to, I guess, maturing the brand and also. It's just a big step in the streetwear industry. And then the next stage, right now we're also prepping, shooting this documentary, which is going to be a good storytelling component for the brand. And then doing a pop-up in Milwaukee, so that's part of the community building.
What day are you leaving for that? Or what's like the transportation plan for that?
So we just made a big purchase, purchased transit that we'll use to carry everything from here to Milwaukee in order to create a space that's somewhat mature from like our past pop-ups. So we want to make this one a bit more just to show the progression of our brand and also our taste and just where we're at. So we're excited. I'm excited for that one too as well.
Yeah, do you want to see it? You just got it, right?
Yeah.
Was it a bitch? You were there all morning.
The first day I went there, it took a whole day to get the all the paperwork stuff, and then today again, it took like half day to just to be able to like get everything in place, sign all the documents, get insurance. I feel like a grown up.
That's right.
Just full signature on that one.
Mm-hmm.
I'm his salesperson.
Yeah.
His venture has now began. Bam.
Thank you so much.
All over the United States, his brand will continue to flourish.
One pop-up at a time.
Woo!
This is like the most grown-up thing I've done, just buying a transit.
A transit. What is it? It's a Sprinter van, right?
Well, here, I'll show you. Okay.
Dude, let me go see it. Is it outside?
Yeah, it's outside.
Let's go see it.
The van? Yeah, we would like to do it. Let's do it.
All the cameras. Jesus.
It's intense,
right?
Where's the van? No, seriously, where is it?
He's getting the keys. He put them upstairs.
What?
I don't know.
You know they belong in my key ring. That's my van.
That damn near is your van, bro.
That's my van. Mr. Inventory van.
Dude, this is weird.
I'm gonna close my eyes and then we're gonna do like, tell me to turn around, okay, when it pulls up.
Okay. Keep them close.
Is it there yet?
You guys,
where's
the...
My van.
Oh, shit.
Let's go, kid. Damn, son.
We gotta paint it like
that car right there. You got a flat ass, bro.
Wow.
What's up, baby? Oh, shit. Y'all gonna be testing this.
Yeah!
Let's go! Oh, my God. Aaron, you got working AC? Oh, yeah.
Ooh,
let's go.
We got the...
That's fire.
Big
bro, this is fire as fuck, dude.
Should I fire her up? Everybody get
dude,
in.
Yeah.
Nah, fire it up.
Bro, you can't drive it.
We're not gonna drive. I'm not gonna drive.
Okay.
Someone get in.
Someone get in, bro.
Sick.
Bro, this is lit.
Oh, man. Hey. You hear that?
Windows!
That's money. Got Bluetooth?
That's yours?
Okay.
Hey.
Yo, I'm so fucking proud, man.
This song is so good.
This is sick.
Can I test the speakers? Unfinished Legacy Mobile.
I like that.
No,
name.
I don't like that name. I don't like that.
What do you mean you don't like this?
UL Transit?
The UL Transit?
Let's put like
rapids.
The...
Oh, rapids? We'll do like...
Final... We're gonna do a flame on the side.
Whoa, what the fuck?
Now we gotta really mood board this shit, though.
Yeah, man.
Dude, this calls for more events, like, regularly as fuck.
This is gonna inspire us to do more, like...
Not sure what's going on, guys.
Welcome to DTLA.
Welcome to LA.
We pay monthly. We're gonna find a place.
Netflix and the cronies.
There's one.
So this is Samuel, our newest intern. Really excited to have him as part of this team. He's been really instrumental to our growth. Great energy, just great guy overall. Excited to have him as part of the team. Next, we're driving in our new van through Skid Row onto our next location, which we'll be filming at a rooftop.
Been A1 since day one, you niggas boo boo. Your own boy, you black that you from? Boo boo. Little hoes you went to school with? Boo boo. Baby mama and your new bitch? Boo boo. We was in the hood, 14 with the deuce deuce. 14 years later, going hard like we used to on the dead armies. Everybody wanna talk about who this and who that, who the realest and who whack, or who white and who black. Critics wanna mention that they missed when hip hop was rapping. Motherfucker, if you did, then Killer Mike could be platinum. Y'all priorities fucked up, but energy and rock shit.
Innocent
crowd make my memory but go since.
Always, always, yeah.
Little ice about my bitch, little ice about my foes.
So, Brenna, they want you to go to another spot.
Который боится высоты, поэтому можно его на самый верх поставить? К веревке. Jonathan, so you can just go upstairs on the top level. Подожди, а я не вижу, где... Ксюш, можешь меня тыкнуть пальцем, где Брэма? Так, вот сюда, это...
After a long week of filming and just handling everything in the office, we participated in the Black Flea Market, which happens once a month. And this one specifically is their first year anniversary. So we're really excited to be a part of this. As you can see, our team has been really exhausted. So like really participating on this one did take a lot of like just willpower for us. And I think it's important to be a part of these communities because it's a really great way to connect with other like-minded individual. It's a great way to get our products out there. It's a great way to see people's interaction with what we're creating. And it gives us a really great idea on like what our product and how people talk about our product and what we need to improve and what conversation we need to be having. So really glad to be a part of this community. And if you guys have brands or are artists, try to get out and try to connect with like-minded individual throughout these like communities that you could find in your local areas.
Hey, how you doing? We're at the Black Market Flea. The date is July 25th, right? It's a beautiful day. It's the 1 year anniversary and it's our second time vending, so we're blessed to have this opportunity and be a part of this community once again. Black Market Flea is an amazing place. So many good pieces around, so many vendors with meaning and a lot of knowledge on what they're vending, you know? Like, it's not just like they're trying to make money, they're really trying to provide these resources for the community. So I'm just excited to be here, network with people. Got some cool performances. Hopefully we can highlight that later. Yeah.
Yelling at my brothers like I know that I'm here. Regardless how loud they don't hear. Walking through the crowd, they shed tears. I know I did not disappear. Uphill, I'm battling. I see the cameraman. I see the news stations. Truck parked outside. It's every channel here. Yeah, interview. Cut. Someone just bled out because they got chalk outline, look like the shape of my shadow. Hand go right through the wall if I try touch. There's heaven all around me.
There's heaven all around me. There's heaven all around me. There's heaven, heaven, heaven. No, I can't feel pain, and I can't see the stars. No, I ain't even vain, but I know we could go. There's heaven all around me. 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 No, I can't feel pain, but I can't see the stars. No, I ain't even vain, but I know we could go.
Let me see the footwork.
So nice.
I'm gonna kick it up. We're wrapping up here. Black Market Philly. Sun's going down. Today, I don't know, there's nothing really much to say. We came, we saw, we conquered.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna check. Oh my god.
No, you good, you good. Hold on, let her shout herself out. Yeah, go over there, go over there. No, go over there.
It's called Homage Hunter.
Homage Hunter.
So go follow that.
Go follow that. Yeah, any markets on a consecutive basis that people can see you at?
Like Silver Lake, Black Market Flea, to get Flea. Yeah. I would say Los Feliz, but nah.
Go follow that. Go shout that.
Yeah, go
that.
Follow it. Support your local Sweet. Black-owned business.
Yeah.
Appreciate you.
Oh, what's the name again?
Homage Hunters.
Homage? Sick.
Yeah. It's like, I thought it was like a really dope idea to like put homage in the name because you're paying homage, you know what I'm saying? What do they say? You pay homage?
Yeah.
So you're paying me to have like a nostalgic, you're having a nostalgic piece of, you know, clothing, garments. So.
Is that your Venmo?
No, it's
Damn,
not.
That'd have been sick.
I could make it my Venmo. That'd be cool.
Yeah,
no, it's just my IG at. So, go follow it.
Ideas. That one got
sick.
On. You know what I mean? Put you on some game. I got some tees. I got some, you know, whatever. I got a lot of things.
Went good. Or how we
yeah,
did it?
Yeah, everything went good. We did great. It's not about what we did. It's about what the community did. And they came. They communicated with us. Told us some stories of how they heard about us. A lot of new faces. So it was beautiful, as always. What can I say, man?
Did you have fun?
Did I have fun? I had a great time. Anybody who was here, it is unbelievable. No, for real, it was fun. As soon as everything gets set up and we're just chilling and all we can do is just link and connect and network, then I start having fun, and that's what happened today. So thanks for coming. Thanks for watching.
If you guys made it to the end of this episode, thank you so much. It really means a lot to us, you guys watching all the way through. And I hope that you guys could see that we do put a lot of effort and energy to document our day-to-day and really showcase the true, genuine, raw feeling of like what it takes to run a streetwear brand and all the chaos that happened in between. This week was very chaotic, and I hope you guys could see that across the camera. Please, if you enjoyed the episode, leave a like below, subscribe to this channel, leave a comment. Really trying to hit 100K by the end of this year, and you guys can help us get to that by just pushing us to the algorithm. And lastly, we are currently in Milwaukee. We've documented the whole process of like driving from LA to Milwaukee. So stay tuned for that episode. We'll be showcasing how we were able to put this pop-up together and some of the challenges that came with it, and just like being back home. Really excited to show you guys that. So, peace out. Man, I think it'd be cool as fuck to have retail in here. Someone was like, this gives me early Supreme vibe. I was like, that's cool. But I don't even know what that looks like. I don't think Supreme was DIYing at the store.